things that when we see that things people are doing, mocking the body of Christ in the event like Olympic, and we are starting to think about these kinds of the wickedness are the things that caused God to burn the people of Sodom and Gomorrah, because the body of Christ shall not be dishonored, but honored. Do you understand? So we can say that something must be very wrong with that person who is mocking the body of Christ. We should examine ourselves that before we take this Lord's Supper, or otherwise there is the causes that are connected in taking the Lord's Supper in unworthy way or in incorrectly. The reason that Paul also says that that's the reason some of you are dead and some of you are sick. So the causes of taking the Lord's Supper it wrong way, it can be either premature death, it can be also disease. I have been telling you before about the causes. I was discussing about the causes, and I said that there are some causes which are generational. And we can also see that, I just want to remind you that the story I have been giving to you about Noah. When Noah was drunk, he became drunk, and he was sleeping and he was naked. He became naked, meaning his clothes fall. And his son is called Ham. When he came and he was laughing and he was talking, he was mocking like he was talking to his brothers in the very dishonoring way, in the very mockery way, I was some kind of. And what happened? The brothers, when after they heard this, they took a cloth, they went backward, and they covered their father. When their father woke up, he spoke things against one of the sons of Ham, his name is Canaan. And in this name, so we can count from first generation of Canaan to 10th generation of Canaan. This is where we find the generation of also the other brothers who are the children of Abraham, Shem. A child of Shem, one of them we say that is Abraham. We say that also the children of Canaan, most of them, they wanted to settle in Sodom and Gomorrah. And some of them, they went to settle in some place called Canaan. And Canaan, that is the land of the Canaanites. And some were sitting in the places of Sidon and these areas. But we can see that God called Abraham, the son of Shem, to come and live. He told it that, I am going to give you this place. I greet you all, my friends, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Today, I have a topic I want to discuss with you. And it is called the Lord's Supper and its power. I'm just deciding to talk about this because this is a so very important topic. I'm telling you about the power of the Lord's Supper or the Holy Communion somehow. Why the Lord's Supper? The Lord's Supper is something that Jesus himself has told to his disciples. The day when before he was going to be crucified, Jesus took the bread and a cup of wine, and he gave to his disciples. And he said that, take this for remembering me. Some people, many evangelicals, will be so very disagreeing with me when I use wine. I am totally different from many of evangelicals. Some evangelicals say that it is wrong, it is sin to take it by using wine. But I asked himself, Jesus Christ, I asked himself, Holy Spirit. And that day when I was praying, I ask you, Lord, I'm asking you to reveal to me, what kind of drink did you give to your disciples to take as a Lord's Supper? Because I need to know if it is wine or it is what. And in the Holy Spirit, after some time, I started to feel the whole atmosphere was full of smelling wine. It was very strong wine, and I understood that the Lord has shown me that it was wine that He was directing that I should go to take. So from that day, I went to buy a drink, to buy a bottle of wine. This is what I show you. I just take a little bit of wine on my glass here, my cup. This one, it is very small cup, and I make a bread. I will show you exactly how I make it. And after that, I take it. The first time when I took it, I understood that it is very powerful. Because that day when I took it, then the power of the Holy Spirit was very strong over me. I started to feel I was overwhelmed with the power of the Holy Spirit. It was very strong. That I could not just see. I said that, wow, this is so powerful. And I was filled with the Holy Spirit all day. You understand? And in something about this, because those days when it is about some 3 years ago, I think, those days it was when 3 years, no, it has gone some years, I was asking the Holy Spirit, Jesus showed himself to me. And after when Jesus showed me, this is a very, very powerful story that I have never told this on YouTube here, but I'm thinking about it. Shall I tell you or shall I make a book about it? Because it is a very powerful story. After that, after Jesus showed himself to me, then he sent me some angels to deliver me. And these angels, they came to deliver. Only they were delivering me. They were delivering me from many kinds. They have been delivered from many kinds of demons. And this is something that is a very powerful thing that I needed to talk about. These demons, that time, there were some kind of demons that they were delivering me. They call it the spirit of Antichrist. And these demons, they are demons of Antichrist. They are not so very long. They are very short. They sit on your head. And these demons, they have a problem effect on you. When you are reading Bible, they are causing you, you feel so confused. You know this kind of, you feel so confused that you do not sit correctly. These are the demons that they make people very hard to believe in God. They're very hard to convince to come to Christ. Because I know that these kinds of demons, I also had them. They are called because when I understood that I was revealed that they were the spirits of Antichrist. And these are the spirits those days when I started, this is why I decided to call the Lord to ask me for deliverance. When I read Bible, I was feeling like in my body, I was not feeling so very comfortable. It makes it very hard to do the things of God. And so when the angels were delivering me, there were these demons that were coming. They are very big, and they are size, I think it's some kind of, not so very short, but very, they are fighting with the angels. But you know, the angels, they use them with their hands, and they are very strong, and they pull them out of my head. What I understood that after when I took the Lord's Supper, these demons become very weak. It was very weak. They became like, they were coming out like they were sleeping. They were sleeping. When it was very easy to remove them. They are very weak. When I took them, when I understood these Lord's Supper is very powerful, I decided to take it again. The next day I took this, I discovered that these demons become even more weaker. And they are coming out like they are dead. When I took them for third day, it was every night of the third day, they were coming even more weaker. They were like, their bodies were like rotten tomato, you know, wrong rotten tomato. I was thinking that they can break, and I did not want them to break and to remain in my body. So I decided, because their power is helping them also to be, when they are removing, because when they are a little bit it is very easy to pull them. But when they become too soft, it was too makeable about it. And because this story is very, very powerful, and it just the amazing story that I never thought that something could really happen to me in this real life. Because this Lord's Supper is very, very powerful. Very, very powerful. It has great power. The Bible is warning us that it is very advised to take Lord's Supper correctly. Because if you do not take quality, you become guilty of the body and the blood of Jesus Christ. You know why we take Lord's Supper? We take Lord's Supper. Jesus, when he gave this Lord's Supper, he said that you take it for remembering, for honoring my body, to honoring the blood that I am going to pour down for your sins. That day is the day when Jesus said that today I'm going to be tormented by people, beaten by people, and my blood will be poured so that you shall receive salvation. We honor people who has been fighting for our countries. We say that we honor the militaries who died for our countries. We honor the people we've honor our parents who are died because of, we always honor people who has been left. So Jesus, when we take Lord's Supper, we honor his body. You understand? We remember his death. That's the first thing. But we honor his body. When we honor that he was killed for our sins, you understand? And this is a very important thing. This is a sacrifice that has been made so that we shall receive salvation. So through his blood and through his body, we receive salvation. You understand? So when we take this, that's the Bible is warning us that we shall not take it wrong way.